agriculture and agricultural technology to cater for the accommodation needs of lecturers and students, as well as its secretariat staff. Various projects at the University Teaching and Research Farm were executed under the Needs Assessment Funds called Special Presidential Intervention to avail the students with practical and academic research in the field of agriculture. Another project Professor Akonje embarked upon is the construction of Kaduna Earth Dam to supply adequate water to the university community for irrigation purposes, as well as to assist in the areas of teaching and research activities. The project, which is being executed under the Needs Assessment Funds, began with the construction of reservoir and channels, as well as access road to the dam site.
We presented to council. Council approved that we must construct a dam. So we are now constructing an earth dam. It's about 40% completed. So
the students of the School of Engineering and Engineering Technology were not left out, as engineering workshop complex was constructed during Professor Akonji's tenure. The project, which is TET Fund sponsored, comprises 3 workshops, 2 classrooms, and conveniences for all users. The construction of the second phase of the School of Engineering and Engineering Technology is ongoing. Professor Musbau Adewumi Akonji also evolved strategies to fast-track issuance of certificates and transcripts for job placement and postgraduate training.
Of course, we have started 3 convocation now. Every year there's convocation ceremony. And when you come for convocation ceremony, you collect your certificate and go and move your certificate.
When students are applying, or ex-students are applying for their transcripts, they're able to get their transcripts within a maximum of 10 days. How did we do it? All we did was to ensure that students' results are properly managed in such a way that when the results are needed, we are able to access it immediately.
And we engaged the second best security printing company in Europe to print our certificate.
Realizing the importance of inaugural lecture in the lives of professors, the Vice Chancellor encouraged professors in the university to deliver their inaugural lectures.
Only 24 inaugural lectures had been delivered in the life of the university. He increased the tally to a record number of 60 during his tenure.
I challenge all our professors who have not given inaugural lecture that you is like coronation for traditional office holders. I challenge them that if you are not inaugurated, you are not a proper professor. So they bought into it. We encourage them.
Professor Musbau Adewumi Akonji also evolved strategies to address the challenges of alumni, which prompted their meeting after 35 years.
All over the world, alumni run their university. They take possession of their university. And for the first time in the history of this university, in the 35 years, in 34 years of existence, they organized what they call reunion, where they brought people from Europe, from America, and from everywhere in Nigeria. It was a very great occasion. They were with us for 3 days, and the university also joined them. It was a very, very great thing.
As part of his philanthropic gestures, Dr. Mohammed Ba Bangida donated a building during Professor Akonji's tenure to house the campus radio, established to enhance the productivity of enlightening and entertaining the university community and the public on the happenings around the country. Professor Akonji constructed water fountain at the roundabout main campus to add value to the aesthetic surrounding of the university campus. Professor Akonji's tenure also witnessed the provision of a well-furnished police outpost for the village community, due largely to the high concentration of students residing in the village. Professor Musbau Adewumi Akonji is a conscientious administrator who endeared himself to the unions on campus.
In terms of classrooms, sir, sincerely speaking, just as I've said, he has tried I commend him, but then a lot still need to be done.
He has also instilled discipline, and he tried to carry along the entire university. We may not be agreeing on all things all the time, but at least we are always being informed on one or two things that is going within the system.
As a union leader, I know we do have a very robust relationship with not only him, but his entire management.
Unions are necessary. They serve to put administration on its toe, because they cannot keep quiet. When they see anything wrong, they ask. But we are lucky in this university because our unions engage us in fruitful discussion.
Under the Needs Assessment Fund, Special Presidential Intervention, Professor Akonji upgraded the university's sporting facilities to a much higher standard in both campuses.
Then we have a program every Saturday where we encourage staff and students to do exercise. They call it aerobic dancing. We have it in town, in Boso, we have it here. In fact, a large number of our friends in town, from the ministry, from parastatals, they join us at Boso campus. If you get there on Saturday, you'll be amazed with what you see.
We also took up 3 500 level students drawn from different parts of the country, having secured admission when Professor Musbao Adeyemi Akonji assumed office in 2012.
There is discipline within the students and the lecturers, and also there is this new implementation of time. Everybody is always on time, both the lecturers and the students.
I really enjoy my stay here because I have not encountered any mishmash. I've not really encountered anything that will make me regret in this school. Why? Because he has set out policies that really has helped students to be highly disciplined.
We have noticed some changes in terms of infrastructure, in terms of organizing the students.
The Vice Chancellor designate, Professor Abdullahi Bala, coincidentally drove most of the what we call our achievement, because as Deputy Vice Chancellor administration, then later as academic, he constitutionally chaired most of the things that drove us to this extent. So it's like him continuing, and we knew that there are shortfalls. There are mistakes here and there. Because he was there, it would be easy for him. So I see his era like a glorious cranny of the present era. So we were walking. We are trying to run. He will leap during his next 5 years.
The wife of the Vice Chancellor, Alhaji Aronke Simbiata Koji, has been very supportive, as attested to by Professor Musbao Adeyemi Akonji.
She has been very, very supportive. Very, very supportive. Especially when I was developing my careers.
He's a very, very responsible man. He's a caring father to his children and grandchildren. And whoever that comes around him is always ready to help.
Realizing the appreciable progress recorded by the 6 vice chancellors of the university, we asked Professor Musbao Adeyemi Akonji and the vice chancellor designate, Professor Abdullahi Bala, to speak on the future they foresee for the Federal University of Technology, MENA.
I see a future that will expand the frontier of our academic program, especially in technology-related courses. Then I see a future where we will be able to go into commercial agricultural production.
My coming in is to continue to build on where we have started. And I believe that given the fact that we have laid a good foundation, mine is to build on that.
What about the hobbies of a foremost biochemist, an administrator per excellence, and a fellow of the Academy of Science, which is the highest academic honor that one can aspire to as a scientist? Professor Musbao Adeyemi Akonji speaks.
Before I got here, I would take a taxi to a place about 3 kilometers without holding any money, because I'll trek back. So I've been very used to trek. Then watching television, especially sports, athletics and football. Then reading, I read very widely.
So far, 6 vice chancellors have in their unique ways made contributions to the growth and development of the university. But the 6th substantive vice chancellor of the university, Professor Musbau Adewumi Akoji, will continue to stand out as a man of principles.